We are making a dish. Oh, look at that fly go. Called Panipopo or Panipopo, and it is a Samoan coconut roll dish. What we just did was we added in 1 can of coconut milk and 1 can of water, 1 cup of sugar. What we're gonna do is we're gonna bring this to a boil, and we're gonna add in a little bit of cornstarch to thicken it up just a tiny bit. Meanwhile, I have in this right here, I just have plain old dinner rolls. I bought some frozen stuff, and it's been sitting and rising. They started about this big, so definitely 3 times its size, right? And I lightly sprayed the bottom of that pan. This is made for a 9x13 pan, but like I said, you know, we have a small family. Only my mom and my brother eat this, so nine rolls is gonna be quite a bit. So this is gonna have a lot of leftover. I will probably save it. I'll fill it up and save the rest of it. And then when all of that's gone, and if they want more, then I will make more. So this is set for a 9x13 pan, like I said. You can make your own yeast rolls. It doesn't matter. They're just basically yeast rolls. This was, I bought a bag of 24 rolls for $3.50. So I just went that way. It was simpler, and I've just had it thawing and rising in the oven since I got home from the grocery store. So we'll bring this to a boil, get ready to add the cornstarch to it. I have my oven heated, preheated at 375 degrees because that's what my dinner rolls say. And what we're going to do is, okay, they take 10 to 14 minutes to cook. After 10 minutes, we're going to pull it out and we're going to pour this sauce over it so that it's about, it says anywhere between 1/2 to 3/4 the height of the roll. And so what I'll do is I'll pour that in, and then you put it in and you cook it the rest of the way, and it'll thicken up a little bit more too, and you know, be sucked up into the roll. So like I said, we'll be back. I talk too much, right? Alrighty, we have got it to a boil. So I'm gonna throw this down. I started out actually kind of slow, and it was taking forever. So, oh, it's getting up tall, isn't it? I'm putting this down low, like on medium low, because it says to add in this cornstarch and to let it simmer for 3 minutes. So here we go. Ooh, nice. It made it go down. How awesome. Ooh, nice and thick. Ooh, yummy, and it smells good. 1, 2, 3. Oh, it's on 4 hours. Seriously? No. I did the time. Ha ha! 2, 3. Start. Okay.
I messed up the timer on my oven. Okay, so we're gonna let this go for 3 minutes. I'm gonna continue to stir it because it has sugar in it. I don't want it to burn. And I'm gonna throw this in, since I should have done that a while ago. And then we'll be able to get this show on the road. Oh, that looks so good. I wish you guys could smell it. Oh man, let me zoom you in. Oh yeah. Alrighty people, the 10 minute limit just told. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna pour this over the rolls. Wow, sizzling. And I might have put in a little bit too much, it looks like. Oops. Okay, so this will go back in for the next 4 minutes. When I hollered up at Scott that I was making this, he said, "Is it done?" So, it doesn't seem like it's really cooked. Mmm. That's awesome. Back it goes. We'll be back. I'm kind of disappointed because they didn't get brown on the top, you know, like how rolls normally get brown. But there you go. Panipopo. Enjoy. It smells lovely.